Hello students, welcome to the course Network Theory. In the previous video, we discussed the problems on dependent voltage sources and dependent current sources. Okay, so today in this video, we'll understand what is meant by a super mesh. Okay, and the problems involving the super mesh. A more general technique for mesh analysis, when a current source is common to two meshes, involves the concept of a super mesh. Okay, so far what you have seen is independent voltage source you have seen, then independent current sources if it is there in the outer side, okay, loop outer side, you have equated that to the mesh currents and solved it, okay, like a constraint equation. Okay, similarly, if you have a dependent voltage source, so you have considered it as an independent voltage source you have applied, and then controlled equations you have written. Okay, similarly, if you have a current source, dependent current source, then you have considered it as a independent current source equated to the mesh current, and then you had the controlled equation, that means constraint equation and control equation. Now if the current source, it may be a dependent or independent current source present between two mesh, so you have seen different meshes 1, 2, 3 like that, so if the present between that, so then the, if for example mesh 1 and mesh 2 in between there is a current source, we call mesh 1 and mesh 2 as a super mesh. Okay, so in this case what we will do, so we will write the complete mesh equation for 1 and 2 together. Okay, and the current equating the two currents, two mesh currents, we call it as the constraint equation. Okay, and remaining if any mesh is there, its mesh equation we will write. Clear? A super mesh is created from two meshes that have a current source as a common element. The common source is in the interior of a super mesh. Okay, so if it is exterior, it is a second case. Okay, current source, it is directly equated to mesh current, but it is interior means it is a super mesh. So we thus reduce the number of meshes by one for each current source present. Okay, so we can reduce the mesh equations. So instead of two mesh equations, we'll form one super mesh and one constraint equation. Okay, so understand this concept, we'll solve two problems. Okay, so that you will understand. First problem, note down this. Use mesh analysis to determine the mesh currents I1, I2, I3 for the network shown in figure. Okay, so this is the recent question paper, January 2020. Okay, so previous question paper, 6 marks it is asked, right? So this is the, this one. So how it is called as super mesh now? Okay, so this is the mesh one here. So because I1 is mentioned, so this is the mesh 2, I2 is mentioned, and this is the mesh 3 here. Okay, so all the resistive elements are there. That means it is a DC network. And then you have an independent voltage source, 2 volt in the exterior. Okay, whereas this 1 amp current source, which is present between the mesh 1 and 2. Okay, so which is present between the mesh 1 and 2. So then, so this 1 and 2 forms a super mesh. So you will write a volt, instead of writing two mesh equations, so you'll write the mesh equation considering this two mesh as one. Okay, so just we are combining, so its mesh equation and its mesh equation, both we are combining and writing, it is a super mesh. Okay, and then the this current, we will equate it to this loop mesh current and this mesh current, which is I1 minus I2 equal to 1 amp, is called as constraint equation. So as it is, you are getting two equations, but the way you are getting the equation is different. Okay, then mesh 3, it is a simple mesh as you have solved in previous problems. So just you have to write the mesh equation for equation 3. So you got 3 equations and 3 unknowns. Use the calculator and solve I1, I2, I3. Okay, so that is only the difference. So just we'll see how to solve this super mesh. Okay, so just draw the diagram. Okay, if I'm going fast, so you can pause it and note down. Okay, so now, as I told you, 1 amp current source is present, so it forms a super mesh. So we'll apply the KVL to this one. Okay, so how to write this applying KVL? So here general equation will not again help. Okay, so here you have minus plus, which is equal to 2, right? Minus, here 2 is there, which is between mesh 1 and mesh 3. That's why it is called as 2 into, sorry, I1 minus I3. then come to this straight away. So not consider this, straight away you come. So this one ohm is present between 2 and 3. Okay, so that's why it is 1. So 1 into I2 minus I3, sorry. Okay, my writing. Then you have 2 here, which is exterior. So it is with respect to 2 I2. So minus 2 into equal to 0. Okay, so this is called a super mesh equation. Okay, then we will equate I1 minus I2 equal to 1 amp. So you get the second equation. Then similarly write the third equation. So just we'll see that equations. Okay, so this is what I mentioned. Okay, just write down this. Okay, so applying KVL around. So this is what I read: 2 minus 2 into I1 minus I3 minus I2 minus I3 minus 2 I2 is equal to 0. Okay, so now simplify this: 2 minus 2 I1 minus of minus plus 2 I3 minus I2 minus minus plus I3 minus 2 I2 is equal to 0. So now group the terms I1, I2, I3 separately. So you have only one I1 term. So it is minus 2 I1. Okay, so I have taken right hand side, it is okay, simplified. So it is minus 2 I1. Then you have I2 and minus 2 I2, which is minus 3 I2. And then you have 2 I3 plus I3, which is 3 I3. Okay, and here 2 you have, okay, 2 minus equal to 0. So if I take the current right side and rearrange the equation, so minus becomes plus 2i1, minus 3i2 becomes plus 3i2, plus 3i3 becomes minus 3i3. So 2 will be as it is, left side it will come to right side. Okay, so this is the equation 1. Okay, any doubts here, you can message me. Okay, so this is the super mesh equation and simplified. Now to write the second equation, so already two mesh equations I have combined here. So to get the second equation, I have to write the constraint equation now. Okay, so which is relating the two mesh currents. So constraint equation in this case is I1 minus I2 because it is flowing in this direction, right? In case if its direction is reverse, then you should write I2 minus I1 equal to 1. Okay, so since it is in the direction of I1, so that's why it is plus I1. Minus, it is opposite, minus I2 is equal to the value of current source 1 amp, okay, which is equation 2. Similarly, apply the KVL around mesh 3. Here you can generic equation you can use, okay, or else you can use the KVL also. I3, so that was the current you had there, okay, so plus minus, minus I3 minus I2 minus 2 I3 minus I1, okay. So I think I have made mistake here. I hope so. My calculation will go wrong, I think. Just I will check if it's correct or not. Okay, so this is the mesh I have. Okay, so I have taken it as plus, but it is minus only. Drop, no? So here I have made mistake, so my equation will change. So you correct it, okay? So it is minus I3 minus I3 minus I2 minus 2 I3 minus I1. Okay, so which is between 3 and 2. Which is between 3 and 1. Okay, so I have cancelled it. Actually, no, it is minus I3 minus I3 plus I2 minus 2 I3 plus 2 I1 is equal to 0. Okay, so then it will become plus 2 I1. I have written first. Then I2 only one term is there. Minus 2 minus 1 minus 1. It should be minus 4 here. Okay, so make this correction. Okay, so minus 4 I3. That is the change you will have. Okay, equal to 0. So once you have the three equations, you calculate the current. Okay, so my values may be wrong because I have made mistake here. So you make that minus sign. Okay, so take the calculator now. Okay, substitute in equation mode. A1 is 2, A2 is 3, A1 is 2, B1 is 3, C1 is minus 3, and D1 is 2. Similarly here, I1. Okay, A2 is 1, B2 is minus 1, C2 is 0, I3 term is not there, then D3 is equal to 1. Then come to third equation, so A3 is 2, B3 is 1, C3 is minus 4. Okay, here I have made mistake, so you make it minus 4 and D3 is 0. Once you substitute that, you will get the three mesh currents. Okay, I1, I2, I3, I don't know, these answers will come correct. because one of the small mistake make also my answer may go wrong. Okay, so that's why. So I don't suggest this value. So whatever your calculator will give value, so that you do. Okay. So these things. Okay. So I have made mistake, but don't think that I have made mistake. So this is just to know you. Okay. So by making one small minus sign, how it changes the value of all the three currents, and your total problem will go wrong. Okay. So this is the strength of the mathematics. Okay. So be careful. Okay. So you get the new values and write over here. Okay. So we'll go for same second problem. We'll see based on the same analysis. Okay. So now you can go fast. Okay. Write down the problem. For the network shown in figure, find the mesh currents I1, I2 and I3. Okay. So it is 17 scheme. Previously it was asked last year, January 19th year. Okay. So here you have the mesh one. Okay. So this is the mesh two and this is the mesh three from the current direction. So you have minus plus 10 volt independent voltage source here, and see here you have a dependent current source in between mesh one and two. Okay. So there is a resistor present here. What you will do with this? So you know the one special property of, okay. So series connection of an element with an current source is a current source itself, right? So straight away this resistor we can neglect it, trivial element. Okay. So that's the only current you can keep it over here. Okay. You can write one more network when you are copying down the network only. So you write one statement. So 5 amp current source in series with 1 ohm is a trivial element. So it will be a current source itself, and draw this new network with only current source of 5 amp. Okay. So now you have to apply the super mesh equation for mesh 1 and 2. So how you have to apply? Like this. Okay. So this is the way you have to apply the super mesh equation. 10 I1 minus 1 I1 minus I3, then 3 I2 minus I3, 2 I3. Almost same value you will get, right? So no changes, equal to 0. Then constant equation is I1 minus I2 is equal to 5 amps, okay, which is again downward direction. So it is plus I1 minus I2 equal to 5 amps. Then third loop equation you write minus 2 I3 minus 3 I3 minus I2 minus 1 I3 minus I1 equal to 0. Okay. So use the calculator and solve it. So you'll get the three mesh currents. Simple. So I will leave it to you. You can pause the video here and just calculate it, and then you can verify my answers. Clear? Hope you have done it. We'll go. See, is it your answers are correct? So 5 amp current source is in the common boundary of two meshes. Hence, the mesh 1 and 2 are a super mesh. Either you can use these notations ABCD like that, or mesh 1 and mesh 2 you can say. So apply the KVL around the super mesh. That's what I told you. 10 minus 1 into I1 minus I3 minus 3 I2 minus I3 minus 2 I2 is equal to 0. Simplify it. 10 minus I1 plus I3 minus 3 I2 plus 3 I3 minus 2 I2 is equal to 0. So simplify. So you have only one I1 terms. So I have written it plus because I'm taking right hand side and writing it I1. Then minus 3 I2 minus 2 I2 minus 5 I2. When I take right side, it will become plus 5 I2. Directly I'm writing. Okay. Previously I have shown. Then I3 plus 3 I3 plus 4 1 I3. 4 I3. So if you take right hand side, it will become minus 4 I3. And the 10 as it is you are writing here. Okay. So which is the equation 1. Similarly, constant equation as in the previous case, it was I1 minus I2 was 1. Here it is 5. I1 minus I2 equal to. It may be I2 minus I3 also. Mesh 2 and 3 may be forming a super mesh. Okay. Anything. Okay. So it may not be first mesh and second mesh only. Don't think like that. Because my both problems are same. Don't consider like that. So then consider the third equation as a mesh equation. See here. Here it is correctly done. So there I went mistake. Okay. Minus 1 into I3 minus I1 minus 2 I3 minus 3 I3 minus I2 is equal to 0. So minus I3 minus of minus plus I1 minus 2 I3 minus 3 I3 minus minus plus 3 I2 equal to 0. Group I1 I2 I3. So I1 you write first. Then 1 I2 you have 3 I2. Then I3 minus 2 minus 3 total minus 6 I3 is equal to 0. So this is the third equation. So now use the calculator in equation mode, and same way you solve equation 1, 2 and 3. Okay, A1 is 1, A2 is 5, A3 is minus 4. Sorry, I'm always making mistake. A1 is 1, B1 is 5, C1 is minus 4, D1 is 10. Similarly, A2 is 1, B2 is minus 1, C2 is 0, D2 is 5. Then A3 is 1, B3 is 3, C3 is minus 6, D3 is equal to 0. So when you substitute that, so you'll get this values, 7.5 amps, 2.5 amps and 2.5 amps. Just check out your answers. Is it correct or not? So here I am confident that it is correct, but you try once. Okay, but previous problem, it was wrong. So you need to find the new values. Okay, so with this, the concept of super mesh is clear to you. Okay, so in the next video, we'll solve the mesh analysis for AC networks. Okay, so for that, your calculator will not come handy to you. Okay, so you need to use Cramer's rule and you have to solve it. Okay, so most of the time in question papers, they will ask DC networks only. In case if AC ask, you feel that it is a tough question paper. Okay, so we'll see one problem. So it is very simple, not so difficult. Okay, only thing is inductor capacitor values will come plus J minus J. So some complexity is more compared to this. Okay, so thank you. Go through these problems once again from whatever we have started from mesh analysis. Okay, so in AC networks, I will not consider separately this, that. Okay, so just to solve AC network, I will show you one problem, one or two problem. Okay, thank you. We'll see in the next video.